Hello, I'm Dr. Marianne Teitelbaum, and today we're going to discuss eczema. We're seeing a huge upsurge of eczema in my very busy Ayurvedic practice, especially among children, but also in adults. So let's take a look at why the incidence is increasing, and also why the current treatments are not effectively getting to the root of the problem. So, my teacher and mentor for 20 years, Vaidya Ramakant Mishra, was one of India's greatest Ayurvedic physicians. He sat with me in my practice, teaching me how to manage every disease that walked in the door. He came from a family lineage of Ayurvedic physicians dating back over 5,000 years to the very origins of Ayurveda. And his family's specialty was always dermatology. And in fact, legend has it that they treated Lord Krishna's son for leprosy. And Vaidya Mishra himself was a great dermatologist, which means, in effect, that he treated the whole body, not just the skin. Let me explain what I mean. It's technically incorrect to think of eczema as a skin problem. The skin is the largest organ in the body, and it's just doing what it knows how to do. It's getting rid of toxins all day, every day. It's just that you don't see the toxins as they're continually dumped out onto the skin, unless they're very hot. If they're hot, they'll cause all kinds of itching, burning, and inflammation, creating almost any skin disease you can think of, like contact dermatitis, psoriasis, eczema, even all the autoimmune diseases of the skin you hear about. Now, the wrong way to treat eczema is by giving a steroid cream externally on the skin or taking them internally or both. Yes, the eczema might clear up, and it might be okay to do that in a crisis situation where you can't take the itching and inflammation anymore. But to get to the root of the problem, you have to address several issues. So let's start at the very beginning. When the mother's pregnant with her baby, she's exposing the baby to all the toxins she came in contact with over her whole entire lifetime. Toxins she got from the air pollution, pharmaceuticals she might have taken in the past, bad oil she might have eaten, bad milk, bad water with chemicals in it, fast foods, food sprayed with pesticides, processed foods. In fact, when a baby's born nowadays, it's been noted that they already contain about 200 chemicals in the umbilical cord blood. But during the early childhood years, babies get rid of these toxins through the skin by getting the early childhood diseases like rubella, mumps, and chickenpox. Getting these diseases might not feel great, but it's a necessary rite of passage the child must go through to get rid of the toxins they accumulated from their mother. So nowadays, babies no longer get these minor childhood diseases because they're no longer circulating within the population. So as a result, the toxins continue to sit in their cells and new toxins come into their bodies with the astounding amount of pharmaceuticals they're exposed to between their highly rigorous vaccination schedule combined with the overuse of antibiotics and many other medications. So, if the toxins come into the body, they must eventually come out, just common sense. And they come out through the bowel movement, the urine, and the sweat. So you won't see them in the bowel movement and the urine, but you will definitely see them on the skin as they come out through the sweat. The reason you see them on the skin is because they're very hot and acidic. See, just like the alkaline rain, which picks up the chemicals as it goes through the air pollution on its way to Earth, turning it into acid rain, the same thing is happening inside our bodies. These acid chemicals burn the skin as they come through the delicate pores. I remember when Dr. Mishra had first come from India. At that time, people in the villages were eating very healthy, and the children didn't have the huge exposure to the high amounts of pharmaceuticals we have in this country. He was in shock at the amount of toxins he found through pulse diagnosis in the children he saw when he sat with me in my practice. And he told me that the amount of toxins that the four-year-olds had in their tissues already would normally have taken a whole lifetime to accumulate, kind of like the pulse you would normally feel of a 70-year-old. He concluded that it was the nasty diet the children were raised on, combined with the overexposure to pharmaceuticals, that created this huge amount of toxicity. So their skin was doing them a favor, getting rid of as many toxins as it could. He taught me how to correctly treat these children and also adults who were streaming into our office every week, suffering from weeping, itching, and highly inflammatory eczema. So first, like any disease, you have to start by tracing its origins all the way back to faulty digestion. If digestion isn't working properly, the food ends up sitting undigested in the gut, fermenting and forming an acid toxin, which adds to the acid chemical toxins already coming out through the skin. The pharmaceuticals that children take in the early childhood years destroy the friendly bacteria in the gut. So we must regrow that first, because it's needed to properly digest and assimilate the nutrients from the food they eat. Next, we have to cool the heat in the liver, because it's overwhelmed from all these hundreds of toxins circulating through it. Don't forget, it's the main filter of toxins. That's where toxins go first when they enter the body. And as these acid toxins are going through the liver, every day it ends up overheating. But the liver makes the blood from the food you eat. So now the blood becomes overheated, which in turn heats up the toxins sitting in the blood. And this is what forms eczema, as these very hot toxins come out onto the skin. And you can actually feel this heat in both the liver and the blood when you take their pulse. See, it's different. Here in America, when we feel the pulse, we're just feeling the rate and rhythm of the heartbeat in the pulse, just those two things. But in Ayurveda pulse diagnosis, you can determine different types of toxins, where they've traveled to, the health of all the organs and glands, the health of the seven tissues in the body, and much, much more information. So it's very different than our pulse diagnosis here in the West. And like the friendly bacteria in the gut, the liver is also considered the seat of digestion, which means that both have to be working correctly in order for the food to be digested. The liver has to intelligently break the food down and send it on its way. But when it's hot and angry, it ends up oxidizing the food, which means that it turns it into a very hot reactive poison right away, instead of digesting it correctly. And now this adds to the load of the other acid toxins coming through the skin. So it's bad enough that the children never get to get rid of the toxins they receive from their mothers. Then they're given too many drugs at such an early age. Combine this with a highly processed diet. But now even the good food they're eating gets turned into acid toxins because the two seats of digestion, the friendly bacteria in the gut and the liver, are now malfunctioning, turning all the food into an acid poison. No wonder the skin is dumping such an overload of toxins, which we call eczema, and think that a cortisone cream will do the trick. So the best way to treat it is like this. First, we have to fix both the friendly bacteria in the gut and cool down the heat in the liver. We have very specific herbs for all of these things. Then we have to stop the reactivity of the toxins coming through the skin, and then direct the toxins away from the skin and into the urine. We have very specific teas that do that. We also have to change their diet so they stop taking in more toxins, which the skin will be all too happy to help them get rid of. And there's one more thing that Vaidrit Mishra taught me, which is an amazing fact. As we were seeing all the skin conditions coming in every day, he would tell me that what you're actually looking at when you see all these problems on the skin, whether it's eczema, psoriasis, or any skin condition, you are in fact looking at toxins that were in the bone marrow coming through the skin. So you might wonder, how do toxins get in the bone marrow? Because it's a tissue that's very deep, hidden inside the structure of our hard bones. It turns out that the modern chemicals like pharmaceuticals, air pollution, and pesticides do go straight to the bone marrow, which accounts for the epidemic levels of skin conditions that we're treating nowadays in both our children and adults. So now we have to clean the bone marrow very slowly and carefully so as not to aggravate the skin condition, which could sometimes happen if you go too fast. That's because as the toxins come out of the bone marrow, they're then dumped into the skin, and it could actually aggravate any pre-existing skin condition. But Vaidya Mishra taught me how to be careful and so our patients usually do quite well and don't suffer this side effect of cleansing. We also, of course, have to change their diets to a more wholesome one with less chemicals and fast foods. Any made herbal lotions to put on the skin and medicated oils with antihistamine herbs and turmeric to stop the itching and reactivity of the skin. He told me that the reason that the cortisone creams work so well is because they actually stop the detox process. So the skin stops dumping the toxins, which makes the symptoms go away. But the symptoms can return full force once the steroid is stopped, or even worse, if you push the toxins back in, they'll just continue to accumulate in the liver and bone marrow and many other tissues, creating a more serious autoimmune disease or cancer in the long run. This is why he would tell people how lucky they were when he was evaluating their skin condition. He would always say to them, "See how the toxins are damaging your skin on the way out? You're lucky they're coming out. Just think if they traveled to your brain and caused Alzheimer's, or stayed in the liver and caused liver cancer, or maybe remained stuck in the bone marrow, causing a serious autoimmune disease. So now you see there's hope for you or your child's eczema, an approach that is much more holistic. It's non-toxic with no side effects, using only herbs, spices, and food for healing. And the most important of all, it gets to the root of the problem. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for listening.